हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, आवर सब्जेक्ट इज एनालॉग इलेक्ट्रॉनिक सर्किट्स। सो द टाइटल इज इटसेल्फ AEC। AEC मींस, ए मींस एनालॉग एंड ई मींस इलेक्ट्रॉनिक, सी मींस सर्किट्स। नाउ फर्स्ट वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट द टाइटल ऑफ आवर सब्जेक्ट। फर्स्ट, व्हाट इज द मीनिंग ऑफ एनालॉग? हियर the meaning of analog circuit is an analog circuit is a circuit with continuous and variable signal. So that signal must be continuous and it must be variable. For example, we can take a sinusoidal signal. Sinusoidal signal is a continuous signal and variable signal, and we can use the square wave. Look at the square wave. Square wave also the continuous and variable signals. These are the analog signals. For example, we have some signal. This is the one of the signal, but this is not a analog signal. This is the analog signal. This is analog signal. Why it is not analog signal? There is no continuity in the waveform. What is electronic? Electronic means deals with the flow of charge carriers in diodes, BJT, FET, op-amps. Electronic means simply deals with flow of charge carriers. Look at here, flow of charge carriers. In the electronics, we will discuss about the first diodes. Another one is the BJT, means bipolar junction transistor. Third is FET, field effect transistor. Fourth is op-amp, operational amplifiers. The most important thing is these all are made with the semiconductors. Those are silicon and germanium. Silicon, germanium are the semiconductors. So electronic study means complete semiconductor study. We are discussing about the semiconductors. Generally we have three types of conduction. One is metals, one is conductors, another one is semiconductors, another one is insulators. Conductors means full flow, semiconductors means semi flow, insulators means there is an insulation for the flow of the current. Understand? Yes. First, we will discuss different electronic circuits. So we already discussed electronic circuit means in that electronic we are using the semiconductors. First, we have three types of electronic circuits. First is analog circuit. Second one is digital circuit. Third one is mixed signal circuit. What is the meaning of analog circuit? Analog circuit means that system consisting of input as analog signal and output is also the analog signal. That is known as the analog circuit. What is the digital circuit? Digital circuit means the system input is known as the digital signal and output is known as the output also having the digital signal. What is the meaning of digital signal? Digital signal means the signal it consisting of zeros and ones. In the form of zeros and ones, the signal is known as the digital signal. For example, a signal is like that. This is the one signal, one and 0 1 0 1. So this is the 0, this is the 1, like that. This is also called a digital signal. And mixed signal means name itself is a mixing of signals. Mixing of signals means input may be analog signal as well as digital signal. It may be analog or it may be digital. And output is also, it may be analog or it may be digital. It is the mixed combination. It is the mixed combination. For example, input may be analog and output may be digital. Input may be digital and output may be analog. Any type of input we can use, that is the mixed signal. In our subject, we will discuss about the analog electronic circuits. That means we are discussing the circuit consisting of the analog input and analog output. Analog input and analog output. Understand? This is about the introduction of our subject. Now we will move into the first unit one. In that unit one, first topic is the diode. Diode is the first topic. So first, diode means this is the symbol of diode. The symbol arrow and the one line is there. This is the symbol of diode. This is the positive semiconductor represented with, this is the negative semiconductor. And positive terminal is known as the anode. Negative terminal is known as the cathode. These are the terminals of the diode. Now we will discuss how the diode formation is possible. In that, one half is doped by a p-type impurity and the other half is doped by n-type impurity. A p-n junction is formed. Look at here. This is the p-type silicon material and this is the n-type silicon material. Look at here. This is the p-type silicon material and n-type silicon material. Those are combined form. Then p-n junction is formed. Look at here. This is the p, this is the n. This is known as p-n junction. First p-n junction is formed initially. The plane dividing the two halves are zones is called p-n junction. So two halves and zones it will be formed. This is called the p-n junction. The n-type material has high concentration of free electrons. N-type material means generally, you know that n-type material means, so that semiconductor consisting of the electrons like this, more number of electrons and the less number of holes. Majority carriers are electrons and minority carriers are holes. While p-type material has high concentration of holes. So p-type means more positive charges, that is, look at here, more positive charges, 1, 2, 3, 5, 6. This is the more positive charges and holes. We have less charges, we have electrons. These are the majority charge carriers and these are the minority charge carriers. Therefore, at the junction, there is a tendency of free electrons to diffuse over to P side and the holes in N side. So whenever we are combined like this, there is a tendency, there is a chance of free electrons to diffuse over to P side. So from this, electrons will move into the P side and the holes of the and the holes into N side. Holes is from this N side. This process is called diffusion. This is known as a diffusion. Whenever combined together, the some of the holes will be formed entering into the n-type, some of the electrons will be entering into the p-type. This is called as the diffusion. As free electrons move across the junction, as the free electrons moves across the junction from n-type to p-type, and the donor atoms become positively charged. Look at here. Whenever the free electrons move like this, it is positively charged. Hence, a positive charge is built on N side. Look at here. For example, this is the positive charge formation of N side. Look at here. Yes. The free electrons that cross the junction uncover the negative acceptor ions filling by the holes. So look at here, filling by the holes. Therefore, a negative charge is developed on the P side of the junction. This is the P side of the junction. Look at here. So negative charge is formed P side of the junction like that. The net negative charge on the P side prevents further diffusion of electrons into P side. So here, P side net negative charge is not giving to chance to go to the N side. Similarly, the net positive charge on the N side repels the hole crossing from the P side to N side. This is also repulse. Yes. Thus, a barrier is set up near the junction, which prevents the further movement of charge carriers. So whenever this is formed, This acts as a barrier or depletion layer. Whenever a barrier is formed, there is no flow for the current from n-type to p-type and p-type to n-type as a consequence of induced electric field across the depletion layer. Due to this, automatically one side is positively charged, another side is negatively charged, then the induced field is across the depletion layer. So this is the formation of the p-n junction. And electrostatic potential difference is established between the p and n regions. Here this is electrostatic field, one side is positive and another side is negative. The electrostatic field is formed here, which are called the potential barrier. This is known as the potential barrier or junction barrier. The another name is the junction barrier. Barrier means it stops. Barrier means stop. Diffusion potential or contact potential. More number of names. This is known as again the diffusion potential or the contact potential. These are the more number of names. V naught. So it will form some voltage V naught. The another name of the V naught also cut-in voltage. In order to flow the current from P to N or N to P, we have to cut this voltage, right? The magnitude of the contact potential V naught varies doping levels and temperature. So generally this V naught value will depends on doping levels as well as temperature. This is most important point. Whenever doping levels are increases, automatically V naught value varied, and temperature will also decides the doping. Temperature also decides the barrier V naught. Okay, so these are the two major important things for barrier. V naught is 0.3 volts for germanium, 0.7 volt for silicon. So for germanium, cut-in voltage is less, and silicon it is somewhat better, 0.7, somewhat more compared with the germanium. Okay, this is about this complete information about the how to form the p-n junction diode and depletion layer and the cut-in voltage, all those things, right? Next we will move on to next topic, forward biased junction diode. For example, if we have a junction diode is there, if we are forwardly biased means the positive charge is connected to the p side and negative charge is connected to the n side. This is known as the forward bias. Biasing means giving some force. Biasing means forward bias means move on to forward side, right? When a diode is connected in a forward bias condition, a negative voltage is applied to the n-type and a positive voltage is applied to the p-type. Look at here, negative voltage is applied to the, this is n-type, and positive is applied to the p-type. If this external voltage becomes greater than the value of the potential barrier, approximately 0.7. So generally we have the barrier voltage or depletion voltage is, you know, that the 0.7 or 0.3. okay, germanium is 0.3, silicon is 0.7. okay, silicon and 0.3 for germanium. So if you giving more than this voltage, for example the input voltage is more than this voltage, 0.3 volts for germanium, the potential barrier opposition will be overcome and current will start flow. So there is a barrier is there, the barrier will be overcome, that voltage will be overcome, then automatically current will start flow. Then the current will start flow. Look at here, we are giving the negative to n-type region, positive to here region, then automatically whenever very small depletion layer is there, that layer potential will be overcome whenever the given input voltage is more than the this cut-in voltage. So these are the symbol is like this only. then the current will be flow like this. Maximum current will be flow. Then the diode, look at here, diode negative side, positive side. Whenever we are giving the forward bias, initially diode is like a open switch. Whenever if you forward bias this diode, then automatically it become as a short circuit, or we can call it as a closed switch. It will be acts as a closed switch. These are the switching applications only. Switching applications only, right? And the application of the forward bias voltage on the junction diode results in the depletion layer becoming very thin. So by increasing this, this automatically depletion layer will be thin and narrow, which represents a low impedance path through the junction. So automatically there is a low impedance path will be formed, allowing the high currents to flow. So automatically the high currents flow will be started. The point at which the sudden increase in the current take place is represented by the static current voltage characteristics curve. So look at here, this is the, for example, we have a diode is there, we have a diode, already we discussed, we forward bias this diode, this is the input voltage, this is the current. Yes, so it's initially we are increasing the voltage, current will be slowly increase, but whenever it crosses, this is the cut-in voltage or knee voltage, then automatically the slight increase in the voltage, how much increase in the current. So by increasing the voltage, the current will be increases, then it follows, the current will be increases like this. This cut-in voltage already mentioned 0.3 volts for the germanium and 0.7 volts for the silicon. 0.7 volts for the silicon. Okay. Yeah. The point at which the sudden, this known as the knee point. This point is known as the knee point. It's look like a knee. Generally, it's look like a knee. That's why it's called a knee. And this voltage, the another name is the cut-in voltage. The another name of this voltage is cut-in voltage. Whenever we are increasing the cut-in voltage automatically, whenever we are overcome the cut-in voltage, the junction will come into the forward bias, the more amount of current will be flow from the anode to cathode. Look at here, anode is connected to P side always, cathode is N side terminal. This is the conventional current flow, right? If the junction is reverse biased, reversed biased junction diode, for example, when a diode is connected to a reverse bias condition, look at here, this is the positive side p-type, this is the p-type is connected to the negative side, and this is the n-type is connected to the positive side. This is the reverse biasing case. When a diode is connected to the reverse bias condition, a positive voltage is applied to the n-type material and a negative voltage is applied to the p-type material. Look at here, this positive voltage is applied to n-type and negative voltage is applied to p-type. The positive voltage is applied to the n-type material, attracts the electrons towards the positive electrode. Look at here, this is the plus, this is the minus. Minus plus automatically attracts, so electrons will be come this side. Okay, while the holes in the p-type are also attracted away from the junction towards the negative side. Look at here, this is the positive holes or will be attracted. So automatically this will be come to this terminal. The net result is the depletion layer grows wider due to the lack of electrons. Then I look at here, there is no electrons in this region. Then whenever there is no electrons, means electrons and holes, means depletion rate will be increases and represents the high impedance path. Automatically it will become, the impedance will be very very high. High impedance path. High impedance path means in order to overcome this, it requires the more amount of voltage. So this is almost an insulator. What is an insulator? Insulator, simply insulator means resist, it consisting of the resistance is very very high. Never allows the current. Current never allows. Very very less. Current never allows. Right. The result is that high potential barrier is created, thus preventing a current flowing through the semiconductor manifold. So we do that high impedance path. So semiconductor material, it consisting of the preventing a current, that means there is no flow for the current in this material because high impedance path. This condition is presented by the high resistance value to the PN junction, practically zero current flow. So this is called generally zero current flow to the junction diode with the increase in the bias voltage. So whenever we increase in the bias voltage, automatically the current will be less. However, a very small leakage current does flow through the junction, which can be measured in microamperes. So very, very less amount of current will be flowing, very, very microamperes, very, very less microamperes current. It not considerable actually. At a final point, if the reverse bias VR applied to the diode increases, for example, we are still increasing the voltage to a sufficiently high enough the value, it will cause the PN junction to overheat. Whenever leakage current increases, automatically what is the problem? Temperature will be increases. This temperature will give the overheat of the any device, overheat of the any device. So we are leakage, we are increasing the negative side of the current, then automatically leakage current will be increases. Whenever the leakage current increases, temperature will be increases. Temperature will be increases, the heat of the diode will be increases. So overheat and fail due to the avalanche effect around the junction. Automatically due to the avalanche effect, this is the one of the effect, the junction will be, whenever leakage current increases, automatically temperature will be increases, around the junction will be increases. This may cause diode become shorted. Automatically diode become short and will results flow maximum circuit current. Then it become maximum current circuit will be flowing that. And this shown in step down slope in the reverse static characteristics curve below. So this is the curve. It become the short, and we are missing some point, that is junction will be damaged here. Junction will damage, it will not recover. If this reverse bias voltage is applied, for example, at 0 to 20 volts, it will produce 20 nanoamperes, let's for example 5 nanoamperes. Up to whenever it reaches the IT, slowly 10 amperes. Whenever it more than 80, automatically the junction will become short. Overheat, junction will be damaged, it becomes short circuit, the current will be increases very, very high. This is known as the reverse breakdown region. This is reverse bias voltage. Reverse bias voltage means negative voltage. Okay, curve is follows like this. This is the reverse bias current. Okay, yes, this is about the diode and forward bias of the diode and reverse bias of the diode. Okay, I think all of you understand this class. Thank you.